I'm also when we are discussing about class 11 physics chapter number 6. In this lecture, we are discussing about the work energy theorem. Okay, so in the work energy theorem, we have understood first of all what is the. There are two things. Is that first thing is that the rectilinear motion. First one is the rectilinear motion. Rectilinear motion. Okay, and second thing is that in the three dimension. In a three dimension. So see here, first thing, both the things is equally near to the same, but something is different is that, so I will explain in details, but first of all, what is the rectilinear motion? So rectilinear motion in the third chapter, we already know about that. So first of all, what is the rectilinear, in the there are the equation, we are using the equations, okay, rectilinear motion's equation is that. So first equation is that v square minus u square is equal to 2as, okay, rectilinear motion. Also it is known as the speed line in the third chapter. Speed line. Okay, so see here, this one also is equal to 2as. So see here, first of all, first thing is that, what is the first thing? V square is equal to our final velocity, okay? It is our final velocity. It is our final velocity. Second thing is that u is equal to our initial velocity. Okay, it is our initial velocity. It is our final velocity, and c a is our acceleration. S is our distance. Okay, it is our distance. In the So see here, final velocity, initial velocity, acceleration. Now first of all, final velocity and the initial velocity, what is the basic difference is that? Okay, final velocity and initial velocity. So final velocity, suppose we have an object is that, see it has a mass m. Okay, it is a place on speed bar. Okay, so we are applying some force on this object. Some force applied on that. So how much force is that? That F is all equal to force F. It has a mass, value of mass is m. So and then its velocity, initial velocity, because of it is in initial condition, it has a velocity that u. So that's why we are going to see that in that term, whenever we are applying something force to the object, on that time we will try to go through the motions. So see, on that time what will happen? There is a something velocity is that. So it is a velocity u, it is a velocity, it is represented at the initial velocity. Now, then after, what will happen? What will happen? Wherever we are applying the force on that, it has a mass also is that, and it has a, we will be trying to the motion on that time, it has a velocity is that. So due to the velocity, it will be changed its position. It will be changed to its position from one point to another point. One initial step to the final step on that time, something difference is that. So see here, we will reach at this point position, it has a value of m. So, but velocity, initial velocity, will not be same. Okay, sometimes it will be same. However, because when you are applying the force, it will be similarly same. And because constant force is on that time, but and also acceleration will be same on that time. This will happen. But see here, the acceleration will be changed on that time. What will happen? Velocity will be changed. So see here, this our initial velocity is that. See our final velocity is v. So see here, u and v. So f is equal to it is our initial velocity. Final velocity will be changed. Why? Because of A is equal to what acceleration is, A is equal to F by M. Okay, so force will be changed. The mass will be constant, the mass will be constant, the force will be changed, the acceleration will be changed. So it is represented as the F. So A it is equal to F by M. So that's why the final velocity will be changed. So it is that therefore we are taking that the V square minus U square is equal to 2As. So whenever it has a velocity is that, so it will be traveling from distance from one point to another point. It will be going to the one point to one position to another position. So it has a distance is that. So see here in this lecture. So first of all, whenever it is position to region, however, it is a distance as, okay, it is a distance as. So we are considering that the four things. First one is the initial velocity, second one is the final. We are considering as here v square minus u square is equal to s. V square minus u square is equal to 2as. Okay, so v square minus u square is equal to s. Now multiply both sides. Both the side m by 2. Okay, you have multiplied both the side m by 2. So see here m into e square divided by 2 minus m into u square, m into u square divided by 2 is equals to 2 into 2 m a s. So 2 will be cancelled out. So see here what will get, we get the 1 half. Minus 1 half mu square, it is equals to n into a into s. But we know that whenever it has something, so the half of mass into the square of the velocity, it will be used to the kinetic energy. Okay, it will be used to the kinetic energy. So that's what we are considering, that it is a kinetic energy due to the final velocity. So we are considering that the due to the initial velocity, we will consider that the ki, it is equals to f into s. How f will become? How f will become in this equation? So we know that our Newton's second rule, that f is equals to ma. Okay, so here see that the ma. So that's why you have to mean that the f is ma is equals to f. But your another thing is gone. What is that? F w is equals to f. Distance or displacement. Okay, it is a distance or maybe displacement. So W is equal to what? It is equal to F into V. So it is equal to, see here, we can write down K F minus K of I is equal to W. So see this equation, how it's related. See first our topic start from the work energy here. So how it's related? The work is equal to the change in kinetic energy of a particle is equals to the work done on it by the net force. Okay, so the change in the kinetic energy will be used to the work done, how much work is done on the due to the rectilinear motions. So this is our rectilinear due to the rectilinear motions in a straight line motions. Now whenever we are considering as whenever now see here this is our see this is to this topic. Now we have another thing is that second thing is that what is second thing of or what is the second thing? Whenever we are discussing the three dimension, whenever we are discussing about in the three dimensions motions, so see here now in the three dimension we are discussing about the three dimensions motion. So first of all, what will happen? See, this is equation will be remains same, but something is different in this equation. I will show you. What is the difference is that rectilinear motion, v square minus u square is equal to 2a. Here vector is that. And what is the v square? V square is the net velocity. Why we are considering net velocity? Because suppose this object is there, and in the three dimension there are the velocity in this direction, velocity in this direction, velocity in this direction, velocity in this direction. So something and the result, it is all kind of all is a vector. It is all vector what it is there. So result of velocity in this direction. So here so you consider in V and you are taking that the V square, so it will be used to the balance V square minus U V square. So net, that's why you are considering the net velocity. Also this is our net velocity. Net velocity. So and also this is our net accelerations on that, how much accelerations of the particle apply on the object. So see here that the net velocity is there. So that's why we are taking that the net velocity. It is in the but we are taking that the v square, that's why it is a scalar. We know about the scalar product of the vector, it will be due to the scalar quantity. So v square minus u square is equal to 2as, but we here v square minus u square is equal to 2a vector a and vector s. Okay, so it will it is equals to 2, sorry, it is equals to f, vector f into s, okay, vector f into s. But what here in the previous lectures, in the English lecture, in this second introduction, we are not considering the vector f, but here we are considering vector f because just because whenever the velocity will be applied on that, in the vector quantity on the time and it has got acceleration in vector quantity, so the result force is also in a vector. So that's why f in the vector, we take it with f in vector. So 1/2 mv² - 1/2 mv² is equal to vector f into vector f dot s. So we are taking the scalar product. The scalar product will be the scalar quantity. Okay, so w, we will get the work done is equal to w. So see here, w we can write down that w is equal to what it is equal to. Our, this is our in final. This is our final kinetic energy, this is our initial kinetic energy, so we can again write down that k of f minus ki is equals to w. So w is our, see our, this is our work, work is our net force is that, net work, net due to the net force, how much force will be applied on that. So this is our, the work energy theorem is that. So see, the definition is that. Work energy here is that the change in kinetic energy, the change in kinetic energy, the change in kinetic energy is kinetic energy of a particle is equal to is equals to the work done on it by the net force. Work done by on it by net force. Okay, so see, this is our theorem is that. So the work and the work energy here, this is our work energy is given. And this is our definition is that the change in kinetic energy of a particle is equal to the work done by on it a net force. It means the something of net force applied on the object on that time, it will be reduced to the work, how much work will be done by the force, applying force, it will be changed due to the change in kinetic energy, it will be reduced to the work done, how much work done by the due to the force. So this is our the work energy theorem. So understood? Okay guys.